Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Babatunde. In today's tutorial, we're going to be looking at how we can mask a given value in Angular. Alright, in this card here has the wallet details and the amount and an emoji. When I click on this, it hides the amount. Click on it again, it reveals the amount. Alright, so let's get right into it. We are going to be using an online editor. Basically for web apps and stack plates. And since this is an Angular tutorial, click on Angular. Okay, now we have our application up and running. Over here on the left pane, I have the app folder and I have the app.component.cs for styles, then the template, then TS for logic, and we have our styles.cs for global styles. So I'm just going to set some basic styles. Padding 0, margin 0, and box size and color box. For the font family, going to be going with Poppins. Font family, Poppins, and Sans Serif. So to get our Poppins, we go to fonts.google.com. Already have Poppins here. Click on import. Going to copy this, right, and paste it over here. Okay. So that's about that. And we go to our templates. Going to remove this. And we're going to set a div and we'll give it a class of wrapper. I can type a class of wrapper. All right. And under div, we're going to give it a class of card. All right. So we do h3 for the wallet details. Okay. Okay, and then we do another div with class amount details, and inside this div I want to add a p tag that will contain the value, basically the amount. All right, just like so. Cool. Now let's go over to our app component.cs. I'm going to take out this, and in this place we already declared a class of wrapper in our template, so just come over here and add the styles for it. I want to center the card vertically on the screen. Okay, so to do that, I'll do the position absolute, I'll do the left 50%. And I'll do top 50%, and then I'll transform it, then translate the negative value of 50% again, like so. Okay, all right, so let's go and add our styles for the card. So display flex, the flex direction column, and the background we're going to do 7f00ff. nice. Then column white. So for the padding, I want to do 3rem, 2rem. Okay. And for the width, I want to go with 20rem. Okay. Cool. So let's add a little bit of border radius on the edges. So to do that, border radius 20 pixels. Right, so let's also set our height. Let's do 185. Okay, super. Okay, this looks good. All right, so let's go back to the template. We have done the styles for the wrapper, the card. I really want to add styles to this H3. It contains the wallet details and our mount details. So let's wrap that up here. So for the H3 card H3, do the margin 0.5 rem and 0. Okay, nice. And for the card details, amount details, display is flex, and we want to justify content here and space between. The reason why we are doing this is because we want to add our emoji here. Okay, we have this amount here, 50,000, and we also want to add our emoji. To do that, we need to add a small tag. All right, so this small tag will contain our emoji. I have an emoji here, so something like so. Okay, yeah, basically something like that. So when I click on this, it, you know, carries out a function and hides this value for me. All right, so we are pretty much done with our styles, and we need to do one more thing, and that is we need to add a cursor to our mount, small, so that when we hover on it, we want the cursor to be a pointer. Nice. Okay, so let's close this and let's get down to the logic. So how do we want to go about this? First off, I need a toggle variable, so I'm going to call it toggle amount, all right, of type boolean, and I will set it to true. Okay, over here I'm going to add a click. I'm going to call it max amount. So basically what this does is when you click on it, it hides the value. All right, like so. So let's initialize our function here. Max amount. Let's check if this works. Console.log. Hey, you clicked me. Okay. So let's go to our console. Okay, it works. So when you click on the emoji, it returns, hey, you click me. All right, so that works. I'm going to take this out. So we have our toggle amount. We need a max value. Basically, the max value is going to contain the asterisk. So what we want to do is anytime we click on it, it checks through the amount and counts the number counts the length of the amount, and then returns the equivalent asterisk. Hope that makes sense. All right, so I need an amount. Normally you would do this when if the data is dynamic coming from the server, but since we're not interacting with any backend service, I'm just going to create an amount here as a variable. Of type any, and equals to 5,000. 50,000, and it's this amount I'm going to replace with a static amount here. So I'll take this out, and via string interpolation, I'm going to call the amount here. All right, so we now have this 50,000 coming from our .ts, which is actually nice. Okay, cool. So now we need a variable, we need a variable that is going to store the asterisk. So I'm going to call that maxed value. Okay, I'll leave it like that. So when you click on this, this toggles the emoji. Okay, toggle the amount equals to these dots toggle amount. All right, so I'm going to come over here. I am going to call my toggle here, toggle amount. So when this is clicked, if the toggle amount is true, show this amount. If it's not, then display the max value. Okay, so I'm going to say toggle amount here, this toggle amount, this one, this variable, I'm going to call it here. When you click on this, if this is true, show this. Normally, if you're interacting with a backend service, you also want to put a check for zero in case the value is zero as well. Else, display the maxed amount. So for this emoji, we also want to add our check here. So if the toggle amount is true, right? If the toggle amount is true for our string interpolation, if the toggle amount is true, okay, you want to hide it. All right, paste that here. Else, you just want to show the amount. Okay. So, okay, we have an error somewhere. Let's check this out. This is simply pass. Okay, it says column 13, toggle amount. This, okay, I think it's in the error. Alright, toggle amount. Okay, so we want to hide the value. Alright, and once it's clicked again, reveal the value. So add the second emoji here. Okay. So, okay, this works. Good, nice. All right, so let's go back to our logic. Okay. So, we have to do a check. If the amount is zero, we want to return one asterisk or one star. So, if this dot amount is equals to zero, then return this dot maxed maxed value equals to one asterisk. All right, otherwise we're just going to create a variable here. We're going to call this max length. We're going to loop in through the amounts, so we need the length of the amount, but we need to convert the string. Okay, then dot length. All right, then we need to, using our for loop, run through the length. Okay, let I equals I, one, I is less than equals to the max length. All right, then we do I plus plus. So this amount max value, okay, is equals to this dot max value plus asterisk. So we have our max length here, this amount, and dot to string dot max length, and we are using our for loop to run through the max length. So, and we are saying that this max value is equal to this max value plus the asterisk, basically the number of times you run through this, add this asterisk. So this is equivalent to doing plus equals this. Okay, then you guessed it right, we return this dot max value. Okay, let's check this out. It isn't okay, so let's check what the error is. So we have max value, and so let's come over here, toggle amount. The error is max length is equals to this amount dot to string dot max length. Oh, this is wrong, dot length. All right, let's try this out again. Still not showing. Let's go to our template, toggle amount, amount. If this is true, show this. If it's false, maxed value. Maxed value. Okay, I think that's the error. Maxed value. So let's try this out. Okay, undefined. Why? All right. So we need to clear this maxed value and set it to an empty string. So if I do this, okay, it works now. Cool. Right, let's run this again. So basically we are saying the toggle amount, this amount, so you might want to do a check if you're interacting with the backend service or zero. So you're saying if this is amount or zero, and then max value, which contains our asterisk, and this is where we are toggling that action by calling the maxed amount method. Okay, this is the end of the tutorial. If you like it, make sure you subscribe to this channel and click the like button, and catch you on the next one. Thank you.